I just called over there. Do you have any idea how many pieces of paper and documentation it takes for a new license? It's so ridiculous. I'm sorry, I'll be right there. Just give me a second.
Today, the role of Patrick Drake will be played by Ethan Erickson.
Robin, what is it? Cramps? Did you fall?
No, I'm fine. Well, the baby's fine anyway. I locked my keys in the apartment.
What?
I'm picking the lock.
That's it?
The keys to my apartment, the keys to the house, the keys to the lab, my life, basically?
Robin, you screamed.
Yeah, in frustration.
In frustration, of course, in frustration. I almost had a stroke. And then I called you back. Why didn't you answer the phone?
Because my phone is dead, okay? I didn't have a time to charge it last night. I lay down at 8:30 just to close my eyes for a minute. And of course, I wake up in a pile of drool because I'm exhausted all the time and my mind is like a sieve.
The common side effects of pregnancy.
Says the condescending male. You know, people love to talk about the miracle of childbearing, but their brain isn't going to mush and their body isn't taking on a life of its own.
Taking on another life, you mean? Robin,
whatever.
I know you're used to being in complete control.
Yeah, right now I will settle for a functioning human being.
Well, baby's making demands already. Better get used to it.
Just hold on a second, I almost got it.
You know, there is an age-old custom you might want to explore. It's called getting the super to let you in.
I am not a helpless pregnant person, okay? I am perfectly capable of breaking and entering. You.
Thanks.
That really wasn't necessary.
Nah. You know what? I'll leave a spare key with the wife. She was so absent-minded when she was pregnant. And this one time, she left the car running in the driveway for 3 solid hours. Finally ran out of gas.
Great, something to look forward to.
Hey, have a good one, sir.
Oh, sure, anytime.
All right, well, if we are going to get back to the hospital, we better... Wait a minute. Let me guess. You can't remember where you put the keys.
I just have to retrace my steps. I can't believe that my mom taught me how to pick a lock when I was 10 years old and I can't even break into my own apartment.
Well,
so embarrassing.
Your energies are directed elsewhere at the moment. You know, it's kind of charming.
Charming?
Yeah, you know, the little changes you're going through.
Really? What changes are you referring to? The nausea, my swollen ankles, my lack of energy, or... the flatulence, you know, let's not forget the flatulence.
But it's natural, right? It's like the mood swings.
I'm not having a mood swing right now, okay? I just refuse to be that cliched, absent-minded pregnant woman. From now on, I just have to keep my mind focused on what I'm doing and just think and not... Oh. Ah! See? It's already working. Okay. Let's go.
Oh. Hey, need this?
Dr. Marcus Giona of the Giona Institute in Switzerland and Dr. Henrik Ploen of Berlin's International Hospital.
Hello, I'm Dr. Scorpio. I have taken over Michael Corinthos' case. I'll be happy to brief you.
I'll leave you to discuss this.
Well, thank you so much for your warm welcome and for your cooperation.
Of course. We all want the same thing, for Michael to have the best possible care.
I could have asked for a better surgeon than Dr. Drake. I've gone over some of the tests and scans and... I know the skill it took just to keep Mr. Jackson's stepson alive.
Yeah. I assisted Dr. Drake in the surgery. And I've also managed Michael's post-op drug therapy.
Well, I think it's understood why Mr. Jackson brought us in.
I mean, I could only imagine what it's like to be a parent going through this kind of nightmare.
I know.
I've also started Michael on apalamine, 12 milligrams a day. I've had promising results with other patients who have similar cognitive deficits. I would share with you my ideas for continued care, but I don't want to influence your recommendations. I really hope that you can find a way to help Michael.
Well, there are a lot of cases that are referred to my clinic by doctors who are feeling the same frustration as you do now.
If you don't mind, I'd like to be honest about something else. I know part of the reason you two are here is because Jax is, well, he's a wealthy man who can afford to indulge in his wife's denial. She hasn't been able to accept what's happened to her son. She will cling to any hope, however unrealistic.
I appreciate your candor. Oh, I think we're ready to see the patient now.
Okay. Elizabeth, will you show them to Michael's room, please?
Of course.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right this way.
Yes, I forgot.
No big deal. It was no problem just bringing it by.
You shouldn't have to do that. I hate that my brain is deserting me. I'm really starting to think that I might mess up at work. Were you ever worried about that?
Honestly, I was so just under so much strain when I was pregnant with Jake. Every time I forgot something, I just chalked it up to stress.
Mm. I know things were difficult with Lucky.
Yeah, well, I was living a lie. I mean, I was staying in the marriage for his sake, even though I was in love with Jason, and here I am, a year later, and...
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I know that, we both lost a good friend when Emily died, and I'm here for you, if you need me.
Maybe it is a good thing that I brought this stuff by, because I do need to know. How did you do it? How did you stop loving Jason? I didn't tell you this before. Actually, I haven't told anybody this, but I was seeing Jason in secret. I had decided that I could have a life with him and that my kids would be safe. And then Michael got shot. And now every time I see Jason in the hospital, we act like we don't even know each other. And all the things that were said and all the promises that were made, it's like they never even happened. And I know that's the way it has to be, but I'm having a really hard time with the adjustment.
I don't know what to tell you. I wish that I could offer some wisdom, but the truth is it took me a long time to get over Jason. It took living in Paris and it took falling in love with Patrick.
He is a good guy.
He comes with his own set of problems.
I know I'm not in any position to give advice, but he does love you, and at least his life is safe and stable, right?
Well, don't tell him that, because then he'll think he's boring and want to do something crazy.
Elizabeth, hi.
Hi.
I don't want to interrupt. I just came by to make sure Robin didn't leave the car ignition running.
Ha ha, funny.
Thanks for the talk. And remember, there's no time like the present.
Thank you.
Bye. What was that all about?